Hi, Ezzy from Webex Events here. I'm going to walk you through how to create your community. The first thing to do is click on Create Community. Keep in mind, you can work on anything under My Communities at any time, and when your community is published, any changes you make here in the Socio platform will be reflected in the app within a matter of seconds. First, we'll go through the community basics. The name of the community goes here, and then the description. This could be copied and pasted from a website or info page you have, or otherwise, you can describe what your community is all about. These next two fields are completely internal. Best email to reach you is the main point of contact for the community, and that person should have access to the Webex Events platform. This field is a community estimate, the number of people you are anticipating will join your community, and this helps us track adoption. Select your time zone to indicate which time zone your content will be built in. Among other impacts, users will see agenda items in this time zone as well as their own time zone. And I'll click Next. Next are the privacy settings. This is where you choose how people can gain access to the community. It's a key aspect to think about. The app itself will be available to anyone to download, but you can ensure only the right people get access to the content of your community. The first option is public, which is the quickest way for app users to join the community, but also anyone can access. The second, which is very popular, is the community code. This code must be at least 4 characters long, is always in all caps, and we recommend something that is not easily guessable, but is easy to type on a phone. With this option, only people who have the code can access your community. You could provide the code to your internal team first so they can test out your app, then provide it to your soft launch users, then provide the code to all your community members when you're ready. With this option, you can also hide your community from search results, and users have to enter the code to be able to see and join the community. Invite only is the other common option and the one that is the most secure. In this case, you would upload your list of members or app users to the Webex Events platform, and when they sign up for the app, their email address will have to exactly match what you have on file. Otherwise, they'll see a message that says they aren't on the list. But if they are on the list, they will automatically be able to join the community. So those are the options we have, and if you have any questions about choosing the best privacy setting for your community, please reach out to our support team. You can change the privacy setting at any time, and no matter which you choose, we have templates for app download instructions that you can provide to your users. I'll choose community code and enter 1 here. And before I click Save and Continue, I want to note that you can go back to the basics at any point to make changes. Now we're on the Features page. This is where I can add features to my app. Click the Add Features button and click the features you want to add. You can also add more later or remove them after you've added them. This is where most of your activity in the Webex Events platform will be, but we'll dive more into editing your features and adding content in another video. I've added a few features that are a good fit for my community. Over here on the right, you'll see this live preview that reflects any updates I make in real time. This gives you an idea of how the mobile app will look. I can even drag and drop the order of the features, and the preview will update. Also, keep in mind that after you publish your community, a web app is available as well to view and access that content. But you can see this part at the top looks pretty blank, so let's head over to Appearance. Here's where you can upload your community icon and cover image. So I'll upload an icon now. The icon needs to be square, and we recommend a minimum of 500 by 500 pixels. Our system will help you crop if necessary. The cover image is another design element and shows in the mobile app at this size before joining a community, and when looking at the community's home screen, it shows this narrower view. So I'll add that as well. Since we show this text with your community details in an overlay, we recommend a cover image that has a design or a photo without text. And now that we've added all these pieces of the community, I'd like to show you what it looks like in the mobile app after your community is published and before someone joins it. Anyone can download the app, and if it's shown in the results, they can see your community name, icon, cover image, dates, location, and description. And now let's take a look at the web app, our desktop experience that is available after you publish your community. I'll switch back to the Webex Events platform for the last part under Appearance, our community layouts. We have three different options that you can choose from to customize your app. First is the banners layout, which lets you showcase an unlimited number of custom banners that drive traffic to your sponsors, promotions, upcoming events or webinars, surveys, or any other content. Each banner can link to content already built in your community and can link directly to a location outside of the app, such as your premier sponsor's website. Each banner will show for 5 seconds before automatically rotating to the next banner, or it can be swiped by the user. Next is the Smart Feed, which automatically updates to show app users upcoming sessions you've added to the calendar feature, recent announcements, sponsors if you have those in the Sponsors feature, and other users to connect with. The last option is Features Only, which is great if you want your features and content to be front and center. For this example, I'll choose Banners. And then click Save here at the bottom. Now that we have the community basics and appearance all set up, we can go back into Features, and we'll dive into how to fully build out and customize an awesome and beautiful community in another video.